Good morning, one and all. So today we'll start our class with one more small topic, that is conditional expectation as a random variable. You know what is conditional expectation? Expectation of a random variable x upon a condition on another random variable y. X by y or x upon y. Okay. So we have already studied these formulas. So what is that? Expectation of x given y equal to small y is nothing but what? This is for discrete random variable. Summation over x, x into p x y of x y. What is this? This is a conditional PMF. Okay. Now, so what will happen in case of continuous random variable? What will happen? It becomes integration minus 2 plus infinity x into conditional PDF f x given y of x given y dx. Isn't it? Now, so, but what we want? We want expectation of x given y or x upon y. That is what we want. So now, so once the value of y is given, the above summation or integration yields a numerical value of y. So it will be a function of y. Now, so if you want to find out this expectation of x given y, what do you do? You simply replace small y with capital Y. Suppose, so let me take a simple example. You got something like this. Expectation of x given y equal to small y, you got, let us take 1 by 1 minus y. 1 by 1 minus y. Then what would be the expectation of x given y? In place of small y, you just substitute capital Y. Now, expectation of x given y will be equal to 1 by 1 minus capital Y. Is it okay? First find out this and replace small y with capital Y. You will get conditional expectation as a random variable. Right, so now we move on to one of the important topics of this unit 3. They are covariance and correlation. What is that? Covariance. We have seen already variance. Now we will see what is a covariance. What is a covariance? So covariance of, here we should define for two random variables. Generally we call it as covariance of x comma y. This is the notation of covariance of x comma y. Now, so how it is defined? First of all, how the covariance is defined? Okay, so let us see the definition of the covariance. The covariance of two random variables x and y is defined, denoted by like this, and is defined by expectation of x minus expectation of x into y minus expectation of y. So read it very carefully. What is that? It is defined as expectation of x minus expectation of x minus expectation of x bracket into y minus expectation of y. Or in the simplest form, we can also write this as expectation of x minus mu x. You know what is mu x means? What is that? It is a mean of x. In the same way, y minus mu y. X minus mu x into y minus mu y. Okay. This is the formula for covariance of two random variables. Now, when the covariance of x comma y equal to 0, we say that they are uncorrelated. Please make a note of this point. What point I am saying? If the covariance is 0, if the covariance of x comma y is 0, then they are said to be uncorrelated. Is it okay? Now, so we'll take a special case. If x and y are independent, so what are the condition we write in the form of expectation? Expectation of x into y will be equal to expectation of x into expectation of y. This is the condition for independence of any two random variable in the form of expectation. But what about covariance? What happens to the covariance? If x and y are independent, what happens to the covariance? So first multiply these two. Okay. Now let me write the covariance formula here. Covariance of x comma y equal to expectation of x minus mu x into y minus mu y. That is over, right? So expand the products in the bracket. What will you get? This equal to expectation of x y minus x mu y minus y mu x plus mu x mu y. Here mu x mu y are means, so they will be constants. Now apply the linearity property of this expectation. What will you get? It is nothing but expectation of x y minus mu y. This is out of the expectation into expectation of x. What is that? Mu x. I am writing directly. I hope you understand this. Minus again mu x mu y plus, anyway this is a constant, no? So the mean of constant itself. So mu x mu y. Then what happens? These two will cancel out. So finally, where are we now? So we are at expectation of xy minus mu x mu y. If they are independent, what is expectation of xy? Expectation of x into expectation of y, which means mu x into mu y. So what do you mean by this? Again, what will be the answer? 0. Now, so here what can I say? If, yeah, there I will make two statements. First of all, so let me write this statement. If x and y are independent, their covariance is 0. But so here we made one more point. So I will elaborate here. What is that? If the covariance is 0, what they are called? They are called uncorrelated, isn't it? Next, if x and y are independent, then covariance is equal to 0. Okay. Now, so don't get confused by this statement. If the covariance is 0, it is called uncorrelated. But if x and y are independent, then covariance is 0. So what can you say from these two statements? Any conclusions? Anything you can write? What you can write? If x and y are independent, they are also uncorrelated. However, the reverse is not true or may not be true. Okay, so let me elaborate here. So if they are independent, what will happen? If x and y are independent, their covariance is zero. If the covariance is zero, they are called as uncorrelated. Which means, so if x and y are independent, they are obviously uncorrelated. But the converse may not be true. Converse means if they are uncorrelated, they may not be independent, or may not be independent. That is the meaning. Okay. So let us take a simple example to illustrate the purpose of this relation between uncorrelation and independence. So pair of random variables is you have taken. So and they take a values like this: minus 1 comma 0, 0 comma 1. Minus 1 comma 0, 0 comma minus 1, each with probability 1 by 4. So this is a joint PDF. Sorry, PMF. This is a discrete, no? This is a joint PMF. So that is a joint PMF. Correct? Now we have to find the covariance of this x comma y. So let me draw it here. So they gave us a joint PMF with the values. What is that? What are the values? 1 comma 0. Next, minus 1 comma 0. Next, 0 comma 1. Next, 0 comma minus 1. These are 4 points. All are equiprobable, so the probability of each point is 1 by 4. So what they gave us? This is joint PMF. So what is given to us? So simply, joint PMF means, so probability that x equal to 0 and y equal to 1. Same as probability that x equal to 0, is not there, no? X equal to, okay, sorry. Let me write properly. What is this? X equal to 1 and y equal to 0. What is the probability of this? 1 by 4. In the same way, so there are remaining 3 points. Probability that x equal to minus 1 and y equal to 0. Probability of this also equal to 1 by 4. Like this, you can write remaining 2 also. So what is this actually? This is a joint PMF. How it is defined? P of x comma y of x comma y. Definition is probability that capital X equal to small x and capital Y equal to small y. Do you remember this or not? The joint PMF definition. Like this, so there are 4 points, all are equiprobable. So we have to find the covariance of those random variables x comma y. So let me write the formula of covariance. Firstly, what do we need there? There we need mean of x and mean of y, mu x and mu y. But what is mean of x? What is that? Summation over x, x into px of x. Mean of y, you know, formula. So here, what is not there? It is not given. This is a marginal PMF. But what is given? Joint PMF is given. So from joint PMF, you get marginal PMF of x. How to get? Px of x I want. How to get? Summation over y. Px comma y of x comma y. So if you take summation over y, y will vanish, you are left with only x. This is a marginal PMF, this is a joint PMF. Is it okay? So before that, what are the values of x and y actually? X can take on, here x can be 1, 0, sorry, 1, minus 1. So the values are minus 1, 0, 1. These are the three values they will take. Isn't it? X can be minus 1, 0 or 1. Y can be minus 1, 0, 1. Only these are possibilities. Now, so what is P? Okay. X can take on minus 1, 0, 1 in the same way, otherwise. Okay. Y also take on belongs to minus 1, 0, 1. They take only these values. Is it okay? Now, what I am asking is, what is px of 0? What is px of 0? That is summation over y. It can be 0, it can be minus 1, comma 0, comma 1. Px, comma y of 0, comma y. Px, comma y of 0, comma y. You know why I am writing like this? Actually, here we should have x, comma y. But I am asking for x equal to 0. Now, what are these? What are the values? Y can be minus 1, 0, 1, which means, so px, comma y of minus 0, comma minus 1 plus px, comma y of 0, comma 0 plus px, comma y of, put y equal to minus 1, 0, 1. 0 comma 0, 0 comma minus 1, and what is it? 0 comma 1. So what is p? This is not there, I think. It is origin, no? It is 0. So 0 comma minus 1, 0 comma 1. 0 comma minus 1. What is one more thing? 0 comma minus 1. 0 comma 1. 0 comma minus 1, 0 comma 1. So we are integrating along this y-axis. I mean, we are summing along this y-axis. So sum of these two points. Is it okay? What is that? 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4, 1 by 2. So it is 1 by 2. Is it okay? Next. So find out similarly. So I will write directly. I have done 1. So we can do remaining. So the PM of x is, it is 1 by 2 when x equal to 0. This is, I have found out. So when x equal to 1, how much is this? X equal to minus 1, x equal to 1. You find out. So this is 1 by 4. Obviously, 1 by 4 comma 1 by 4. In a similar way, you have to find out marginal PM of, okay. Here, what is the mean of this? You got PMF, no? So what is the mean of this? Mean of x. What is the formula? Summation over x, x into px of x. Which means 0 into 1 by 2 minus 1 into 1 by 4 plus 1 into 1 by 4. How much is this? 0. Now in the same way, you have to find out marginal PMF of y. Py of y. How to find out? You should take summation over x. P x comma y of x comma y. So here x varies from minus 1, 0, 1. Y also varies from minus 1, 0, 1. You find out this marginal PDF. What do you get? Let us see. So that is also equal to, that is also equal to 1 by 4 when y equal to 1, 0 when y equal to 0. It is 1 by 4 when y equal to minus 1. This is, you get like this. What is the mean of y from the above PDF or PMF? It is also 0. Correct? Now, so what is expectation of xy in the given example? Can you find out? So actually, first of all, what is the formula of this? What is the formula of this? So xy, some double summation over xy, px comma y of x comma y. So here it is very simple. What do you get here is, what is x into y? Small x into small y. What is that? What is x into y? What is 1 into 0? 0. Minus 1 into 0? 0. 0 into minus 1? 0. 0 into 1. Okay. So the product of xy is 0 every time. Okay. Why? Because in all these cases, either x equal to 0 or y equal to 0. You just know you've seen. Either, what is happening here? Either x equal to 0 or y equal to 0. So that what will happen? Enter product will be 0. If everything is 0, summation also 0. This is simple logic. Is it okay? Now here simply mu x equal to 0, mu y equal to 0, expectation of x y is also equal to 0. So this is we got till now. Now let us find the covariance. So covariance of x comma y is equal to, let me write directly, expectation of so x minus mu x into y minus mu y. But just now we have proved that so both are 0. Then this is simply expectation of xy. It is also 0. Just now we have proved. So the covariance is 0. Which means what you can say? What you can say? They are xy, x and y are uncorrelated. Okay. Now the question is, are they independent? The question is, are they independent? How to check independence here? Here, so generally students think that expectation of here is simply what they do is, expect independence we have studied, no? Expectation of xy equal to expectation of x into expectation of y. But remember, this should be true if and only if they are non-zero. If they are non-zero, you can verify the independence from this equation. So they should be non-zero. But what happened here? All are zeros. Mu x is 0, mu y is 0. Okay, it is also 0. So this is not the correct way of verifying independence using this equation in case if there happen to be 0. But what is another method you can see? Px comma y equal to Px into Py. Verify with this. Because I have derived the Pm of x and Pm of y also. Both. You multiply these two. Suppose let me take a simple example. So where x equal to 0 and y equal to 1. X equal to 0, y equal to 1. Multiplying these two. X equal to 0, 1 by 2. Y equal to 1, 1 by 4. What do you get? 1 by 8. Isn't it? So but 1 by 8 is not there. Yeah, all are 1 by 4 only. So what will happen now? Are you getting what I'm saying? This is, they are not equal. So you can say that they are not. See, what I'm saying is, I've just taken one example. So here I'm multiplying two PMFs. X equal to 0, y equal to 1. 1 by 4 into 1 by 2, 1 by 8. But what is joint PMF value will be 1 by 4, because all are 1 by 4s only. There is no 1 by 8 in the joint PMF. Isn't it? So simply they are not independent. So simply you can say that, what a conclusion, if they are independent, if x and y are independent, they are obviously uncorrelated, but converse may or may not be true. Converse is not true. Is it okay? No. So that is about covariance. Now we have a correlation coefficient rho of two random variables x and y, that is a non-zero variances as defined. Here the variance has to be non-zero. Okay. So sigma square x, sigma square y should not be equal to 0. Then rho equal to covariance of x comma y by square root of variance of x into variance of y. This is the formula. It is something like normalization. Okay. It is nothing but normalized version of covariance. Covariance is being normalized. Now what are the values of this? Ranges from minus 1 to plus 1. So rho, correlation coefficient, is covariance of x comma y by, so actually square root of variance, you can write square of square root of variance of x into square root of variance of y. What is the square root of variance? It's called standard deviation. Simply you can also write this as sigma x into sigma y. These are what? Standard deviations, you know already. So what are the values of that? It varies from minus 1 to 1. These are limits of that correlation coefficient. So if x and y are independent or uncorrelated, so rho is 0. Okay. So if they are uncorrelated, rho is 0. Suppose when it is minus 1 and when it is plus 1, can you guess? Suppose y minus mu y equal to x minus mu x, then what is the coefficient of correlation or correlation coefficient for all x comma y? In this condition, what is a rho? Can you guess? Anyone? Okay, I will answer this. So y minus mu y equal to x minus mu x. Sorry, here I should write capital. Capital is small, no problem. Anyway. So rho equal to covariance of x comma y by sigma x into sigma y. Okay. What is the covariance formula? Expectation of x minus mu x into y minus mu y. Isn't it? But here I have taken both as same. Isn't it? So which means what I can write? I will take only one variable, that is x minus mu x whole square. But what is this? What is that? Variance of x. Isn't it? Yes or not? No. Otherwise you can also call this as, suppose if I write reverse, I take y minus mu y whole square. can also take this also, right? Because both are equal. Which means, so covariance of x comma y equal to variance, which not only that, same. Then what is rho will be now? Covariance of x comma y by sigma x into sigma y. Sigma x equal to sigma y. Suppose covariance, let us take sigma x square. Sigma x square by sigma x into sigma y. All are both, they are same. Sigma x square. You will get 1. Okay. Suppose if I take, yeah, in the same way, if x minus mu x equal to some constant c into y minus mu y, then what about the coefficient? It is 1. Still it is 1. In the previous example, I have taken c equal to 1. C can be any value, any positive number. 1 if c is positive. Please make a note of this. So rho equal to 1 if x minus mu x equal to some positive constant c into y minus mu y. If c is negative, x minus mu x equal to some c into y minus mu y. If c is negative, then rho will be how much? Rho equal to minus 1. So these are the limits of rho. I told you rho varies from minus 1 to 1. When rho will be minus 1? In this condition. When rho will be 1? In this condition. Okay. So if they are uncorrelated, there is no rho. Rho is 0. Right? Yeah. So, let us take one of the important definitions now. That is finding the variance. Suppose, for example, I will take here Z is the sum of two random variables. What is variance if they are independent? So what is the variance of Z? That equal to variance of X plus Y. That equal to variance of X plus variance of Y. We know this already. Isn't it? Now here I don't take this condition. Then what is the variance of Z? That is the question. So simply here, that above things we have studied already. Here what I am saying is Z is X plus Y. Okay. What is the variance of Z? Here I am not saying that X and Y are independent. Okay. They need not be independent. If they are not independent, for example, what will happen? Variance of Z equal to variance of X plus Y. How much is this? You have to find out. Before that, what is the expectation of Z? What is the expectation of Z? That is mu x plus mu y. Why? Because I told you. So for expectation operation, we don't need independence. It is always true. Expectation of x plus y equal to expectation of x plus expectation of y. That is true irrespective of whether x and y are independent or not. But variance of x plus y equal to variance of x plus variance of y, if and only if x and y are independent. Now here, you are finding the variance of x plus y by assuming x and y are not independent. But it is true always. No need to worry about the independence of given two random variables. Okay, let us proceed. First of all, what is the variance formula? I am finding the variance of Z formula. So let me go with the basic formula of variance. What is that? So let me call this as mu Z. What is the variance of Z? Z minus mu Z whole square. Is it not? Yes or not? Then next. What is Z? X plus Y. Okay, let us proceed now. That equal to expectation of X plus Y minus, what is mu of Z? Mu X plus mu Y, which means here you can write mu X minus mu Y. Is it okay? Now, here let us rearrange the terms. X minus mu X plus Y minus mu Y. Please make a note of this here. Whole square. Don't forget this. Is it okay? So, for betterment, you call this is A, this is B. I'll tell you what is that exactly. What is A? We are assuming A equal to X minus mu X. What is B? I am assuming Y minus mu Y. Now, what is the variance of Z? Expectation of, what is this? A plus B whole square. Is that it? Expectation of A plus B whole square. Let us elaborate. Expectation of A square plus B square plus 2 into AB. You know already this expectation obeys linearity property, which means expectation of A square plus expectation of B square plus 2 is a constant, you can write outside the expectation, plus 2 into expectation of A into B. So let us resubstitute A and B. What is A? X minus mu X. What is B? Y minus mu Y. Okay. Then variance of Z equal to expectation of X minus mu X whole square plus expectation of B square. What is B? Y minus mu Y whole square plus 2 into expectation of AB. Expectation of AB. What is A? What is B? X minus mu X into Y minus mu Y. Now, so let us write this. What is this? Expectation of X minus mu X whole square. This is sigma X square or variance of X. What is this? Sigma Y square. What is this? Not 2, only this part. Covariance of X comma Y. Which means, so let me write correctly. Variance of X plus Y equal to, what you can say? Variance of X plus variance of what? Y plus 2 into, what is that? Covariance of X comma Y. This is the final result. If they are independent, what will happen? If they are independent, they means X and Y. What will happen? Covariance will be 0. Then what happens? Variance of X plus Y will be equal to variance of X plus variance of Y. So if they are not independent, the extra term you get is what? This term. That is 2 times of covariance of x comma y. So if they're independent, obviously covariance will be zero. You are left with only variance of x and variance of y. Okay, that is the formula for variance of x plus y. So here I have taken only x plus y. Suppose x plus y plus z is there. Otherwise, here in the example, I have written x1 plus x2 plus x3. We have sum of three random variables. Then, what is the variance of x1 plus x2 plus x3? Variance of x1 plus variance of x2 plus variance of x3 plus 2 into common covariance of x1, x2, x1, x3, and x2, x3. All combinations of 2. Here, if you take combinations of 2. Is it okay? Here, so it need not be only of sum of 2 random variables, it can be of sum of any number of random variables. Okay, so if it is 4 random variables, otherwise, suppose if it is sum of 4 random variables, a comma a comma b comma c comma d, what will happen? Variance of a plus b plus c plus d equal to variance of a plus variance of b plus variance of c plus variance of d plus 2 common covariance of ab, ac, ad, bc, bd and cd. So it is just you take 2 at a time, combination of 2 at a time. Selection of 2 from the 4. Now this is the final formula for any generally n number of random variables. Okay, so you should know this, very very important. So variance of x1 plus x2 plus x3 so on so xn equal to variance of x1 plus variance of x2 plus so on so on variance of xn plus 2 into this summation. It denotes selection of 2. Okay, you must remember this properly. You need to remember, you follow this method. If there are 5, A, B, C, D, E, you take A, B, A, C, A, D, A, E, next B, C, B, D, B, E, C, D, C, E, and D, E. You take combination of 2. How many such combinations will get here? How many such combinations will get here? How many you get? You are selecting 2 from a set of n, nc2. nc2 covariances will get. Okay, in this calculation you need n variances, nc2 covariances. You need to calculate n variances, nc2 covariances. Is it okay? Yeah, so let us take a problem. So I think this would be the last in the third unit. Okay, now so I think we have solved this problem already. I hope I given in the assignment at least. I don't remember anyway. Yeah, so n, let n people throw their hat in the box and then pick a hat at random. Let us find the variance of x. X is nothing but what? The number of people that pick their own hat. Number of people who got their own hat. Okay. Right. So how to find out this? We take some random variables. X is nothing but number of people who got their own hat or cap. So we'll write that as x1 plus x2 plus plus on xn, sum of n random variables. What is xi? Here I varies from 1 to n, let us take. Now xi is modeled as Bernoulli random variable. It is modeled as Bernoulli. What Bernoulli says? How it is defined? It takes only two values, it is 1 if it is dead, 0 if it is tail. What is the PMF? if x equal to 1, obviously 1 minus p or q if x equal to 0. So this is what we studied. But here, each and every x1, x2, each and every random variable is Bernoulli. Now, what do we write here? We have n Bernoulli random variables. Please make a note of this. Xi is nothing but 1. When it is 1, if ith person selects own hat, 0 otherwise. Okay. So what the probability of selecting your own hat? What the probability? Probability that xi equal to 1. Xi equal to 1 means what? Ith person should select his own hat. What is the probability? So there are n caps. Among n caps, only one cap is yours. Obviously, you would select 1 over n. We call this as P. So then what is the probability that xi is not equal to 1 or xi equal to 0? Obviously 1 minus P or 1 minus 1 by n. For all n, for all I. I varies from 1 to n. Now what is the PMF you can write here? Pxi of xi that equal to, so what do you got? 1 by n, n minus 1 by n. What is this? N minus 1 by n. Okay, so for if ith person selects his own cap, sorry, I should write 0. Okay, if ith person does not select his own cap. Anyway, okay, so what is the variance of Bernoulli random variable here from this? What is the variance here? Variance of x. What is that? P into 1 minus p. You already studied. You already derived this. That is standard one. The variance of this is p into 1 minus p. Is it right or reverse? You have to check it. Yeah, I hope it is correct. So, variance of which and every random variable is? Variance of xi is p into 1 minus p, means 1 by n into n minus 1 by n. For all I. Here, let me write everything clearly. So that equal to n minus 1 by n square for all I. I varies from 1 to n, which means variance of x1, variance of x2, variance of x3, variance of x, all are same. N minus 1 by n square. Now, so we have to find out covariance. Covariance of xi xj. Okay. Here I should not be equal to 0. I should not be equal to j. What is if I equal to j? What happens? Suppose if I ask you covariance of x comma y. X comma x. What is that? Covariance of x comma x. That is nothing but variance. Okay. Now, so let us find the covariance of xi xj. So what is the formula? Expectation of xi minus mu xi into xj minus mu xj. Now, so if we further simplify this, what do you get? expectation of xi xj. So let us solve this. Now let me simplify this further. Now this will be equal to, I am writing directly, so without wasting much time, expectation of xi xj xi xj minus mu xj into xi. Please be careful, I am writing directly, minus xj into mu xi plus mu xi mu xj. So finally what happens? You take the expectation inside the brackets. Get expectation of xi xj minus, yeah, can you write directly? What this becomes? Mu xi mu xj, isn't it? What this becomes? Minus, this also becomes mu xi mu xj. This is anyway constant, so it is also plus mu xi mu xj. Then what happens? So these two will be cancelled out. We are left with expectation of xi xj minus mu xi mu xj. Is it okay? What is xi? What is the mean of this? Mean means, generally this is a mean, no? Mean of xi. Ith selection means xi, small xi equal to 1. Here small xi equal to 0. What do you mean? This into this plus this into this. 1 into 1 by n. So in the same way for mean of xj is also 1 by n. So this will be 1 by n square. What is this we have to find out? So I am finding expectation of xi xj. What is the best way to find out this? What is the best way? Which means, it implies that probability that xi equal to 1 and xj also equal to 1. Now, so here we can do something. I can write probability that xi equal to 1 into, it is something like joint probability. I am writing this as this into then conditional probability. What do you write? Suppose this is A intersection B, A and B. Then what write? Probability of A into probability of B given A. Which means xj equal to 1 given xi equal to 1. Is it okay? Now, what is the probability that xi equal to 1? 1 by n. Do you agree or not? This is 1 by n. But what is the probability? This is a conditional probability here. What is the answer for this? Anybody? So what condition? What is the probability that jth person will get his own hat, given that the ith person already taken his own hat? So in the box we have only n hats. So already the ith person has taken his own hat, which means you are left with how many hats? N minus 1. From n minus 1 you have to select your own hat. So obviously what is the probability? 1 over n minus 1. So what is the covariance now? This into 1 by n square, which means, so the covariance of xi comma xj equal to, what is that equal to? 1 by n into n minus 1 by 1 by n square. So if you solve this, you will get 1 by n square into n minus 1. This is only covariance, but they are asking variance. Okay? Yeah. Variance of x, which means variance of, okay, it is covariance of for all xij, for all I comma j, which means covariance of x1, x2, x1, x3, x1, x4, all are same. Is it okay? Now what the variance of each and every random variable, what the variance of x1? Variance of x1 is n minus 1 by n square. Variance of x2 also same, x3 also same. Okay, now, so here, yeah, so variance of x means variance of, okay, sorry, here we are finding, yeah, what do you write? Variance of x1 plus variance of x2 plus so on plus variance of xn plus what? What formula says? Observe the formula carefully. Plus one more part is 2 into covariance of combinations of 2. What are they? X1 comma x2 plus covariance of x1 comma x3 plus covariance of x1 comma x4 plus so on. Okay? But as I told you, all are same. Everything, these are all are same. So then here also all covariances are same. So then what happens? But how many such covariances are there? How many? How many combinations will be there? NC2. Okay. Finally, what you can write? So the variance of x equal to variance of x1 plus variance of x2, x and all are same. N into variance of x1. Let me take like this, because all are same, plus 2 into, we have NC2 covariances, all are same. Then what happens? N into NC2 into covariance of x1 comma x2. Anything you can take. Simply I need to know the common covariance. Then what happens? What is the variance of x1? What is the variance of x1? Where have you written? Yeah, n minus 1 by n square. N minus 1 by n square. Is it so? Yeah, so n minus, so then it becomes n into n minus 1 by n square plus 2 into n into, what is nc2? N factorial by n minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial. What is that nc2 value? You find out. N minus 1 by 2. So finally, what will happen here is you get N minus 1 by, okay, I think here we are making a small blunder here, right? What is that is here already I written NC2, you need to write N, correct? So these are number of covariances, no? Sorry, I'm sorry. Yeah, so here what will happen? So finally you get like this. You solve it, you get like this. 1 minus 1 by n, you get is equal to, write like this, equal to 1 minus 1 by n plus 2 into n into n minus 1 by 2 into covariances. Let me write another page. What you get is 1 minus 1 by n plus 2 into n minus 1 by 2 into 1 by n square into n minus 1. So what will happen? 2 cancel, this is n, n minus 1 also cancel, this is n. Okay, yeah, what do you get? This is equal to 1 minus 1 by n plus 1 by n, that equal to 1. Okay, that is the answer. Okay, so we stop here. I hope we have done with the third unit. Thank you.